My name is Shar James, and I'm not sure that I'm going to be able to do this. I'm going to be able to do this. I'm a Dene Navajo from the Navajo Nation. I'm a Red Street running into the Water Clan for Edgewater. My maternal grandfather is Tarring House. My paternal is Black Sheep. And I reside in Arizona, a little small little town called between Sanders and Haupt, Arizona. But I work in Windrop for the Navajo Nation. I've been with the tribe for 30 years, and it's going to be 31 years in October. I am a prevention specialist, a certified prevention specialist with the MSPI Methamphetamine Suicide Prevention Initiative. All the years that I've been with the Navajo Nation, I started off as a CHR and worked in my community, worked my way up to a supervisor, to a manager, up to acting program director with the CHR program. And then I left and then transferred to Department of Behavioral Health Services. That's when I started doing a lot of presentation on methamphetamine on the Navajo Nation in Navajo. Then from there, I transferred to Divisional Social Services, which a program called Navajo Treatment Center for Children and Families. This program deals with child sexual abuse. And so they did a proposal for the MSPI where we got that grant, and I'm under that grant right now. Mm-hmm. So when I was in the field of supervision with the CHR program, mostly my work was very hectic at times, and I had to meet deadlines, and I have children, I have grandchildren also. And at the time when I was with the CHR program, I was doing more paperwork. I thought my work was more important than anything else, like more important than my job. I didn't really pay attention to my kids, what was going on and what was happening. And I know that at the time, you know, one of my son was trying to get my attention to say, "Mom, we need to talk." But I never listened. I just never really communicated. And what I said from here, from my words, was that it was so powerful, I guess, that at times as parents, like today, I say that at times that we don't realize what we say. Our words are so powerful that it can really hurt somebody. It can penetrate your own kids, you know, this one word, whatever that you say to them. So that's, I believe that's what I did. And from there, my son got involved with all drugs and alcohol down here in the Phoenix area. And when he came back, then later on January the 1st, he suicided himself. I know he did because he ran in front of the train. And it was a real, really, really hard for me to deal with that. And it seems like made my life where I had to make that turn, you know, from a management position into what I'm doing today with being a prevention specialist. So when I got into this grant, the MSPI, it's like I already knew what I'm talking about, and I already felt what I'm saying, especially to parents when I tell them that, you know, you have to start communicating with your children. Because when that happened to me, it was like I had to take a real good look at myself. I had to take my heart out and open this heart and to really realize and to understand what's really in this heart. Was there really love? Was there really emotions? Was there all these things? Was it really in their compassion? And come to realize that it seems like it wasn't really there. That's how I found myself. And I had to take a look from my toes all the way to the tip of my head. And then, so it seems like what I said to my son, the words that I have used, it's like driving him away until this has happened. And ever since that time, it's like the management position where I was at, I made a turn to become a prevention specialist. Because now, today, on the Navajo Nation, I'm always doing this every day, traveling here and there to the schools, to parent meetings. I try to get to the parents and let them know, hey, you need to be a good parent. You need to set a rule, good role model for your children. You need to start communicating with them. You need to start saying, Shana, Shiyasha. You hold them right here in your heart. And a lot of us, we never say that. We just call them by their name. Or we would say, shh, you know, that kind of thing. We just tell them, come here, that's it, with no feelings. But I realized that, you know, when you say Shiyasha Shawe in Navajo, that means, my precious child, my dear precious child, I love you so much that you're in my heart every day. You know, that's the word that is so powerful to me today. So every time I talk to the kids, the youth, the children, whoever it is, I say Shiyasha to them right away. It's like something that really catches them, and they would just smile there, and they would tell me, you know what, I never hear that at home, or either I don't even understand what that means. What does that mean? That tells me that this word, what I said, Shiyasha, is never used in the home. And so I try to tell parents, you need to start saying it to your kids. You got to say that every day. It doesn't matter, every day. And just tell them that you love them. Before they walk out that door to go to school, tell them, Shiyasha, have a good day. That's all they want to hear. And a lot of them, asking them these questions, you know, seems like out of 20 students, only about 6 of them, you know, they'll raise their hand. But other than that, you know, some of them will be happy that they hear these things at home. And then they see all these domestic violence, alcohol, drinking, and drugs, and everything. That's what they see. That's what's really hurting our children today. So by that's what I mean. We have to be a good role model for our kids, because our children watch us every day. So when I go to the kids, when I talk to them, I hug them. Shiyasha, oh, no. I pat them on the back. And that really brings tears to their eyes. You know, I know that it makes them feel good. That's the words that they miss at home. So with my job, just hearing and listening to some of the youth, the kids, that's what they miss. And I really, really feel for them. Like some of our children they suicide themselves. And I always wonder, why did it happen? Why? And it all boils back down to the home, where the home is, you know, that's where it starts. And it's sometimes we say, you're so stupid, you're crazy child, you're like this. We point fingers at them. We don't realize how much problem we pack in this plastic bag that they have. Maybe a child's sexual abuse has happened, but they don't want to tell their parents about it. Then from there, I realize that they carry it around like a plastic bag. That sexual abuse will be at the bottom, maybe. And then maybe something happened, domestic, by all these things, it starts packing up. Pretty soon, they can't handle it, and then suicide comes. And that's what I found out through my own children, you know, my own kids. That's my finding. That's the reason why that I really, really, it really touches my heart when some of these kids, when they tell me stories that my mom, my dad, they split. I don't know where to go now. Who do I go to, this way or this way? Or either last night, my mom and dad were fighting. I had to crawl under the bed. I slept there last night. Or either I stayed at grandma's house. And I can't take it no more. They'll say that. They'll tell me these things. But I always bring them back up and I say, Shiyasha, I'm here. Talk to me. If you need a talk, talk to me. Call me. Here's my email, sharjames1215@yahoo.com. Talk to me. Tell me. So you'll be okay. I'll be your mommy, or I'll be your grandma, I tell them. So to this day, I have a lot of children, a lot of kids, you know, they call me, oh, there's Grandma Shar, or either there's my mom, Ma Shar's right there. They'll say that to me. So that's my work that I do, and just to get this message out to the youth, wherever you are, who you are, it's okay. We're all like Native Americans, all of us, we have the same skin. We're all God's children. So if you need to talk to me, call me, or either email me. I'll be there for you. Whatever problem you have, tell me about it. I'll be there, just to hold you, maybe, just to say, Shiyasha, right here in my heart. to make you feel better. So this is how much I want to say to all of you. Maybe there's Navajos wherever, and I hope that you get this message, what I'm saying to you. It's coming from the heart. It's not a lip service. So that's how much I want to say to you. Thank you.